This is Alejandro, and in this video we will be demonstrating how to operate your PC tool from your computer once you have connected it to your Danfoss Digital Ammonia Gas Detector. To learn how to connect it, please watch the video in the description below. Once we have connected the Danfoss PC tool at both ends on the Digital Gas Detector and the computer, we're going to open computer and find that the PC tool is actually seen as a storage device. We're gonna open the folder called PCE06, and here we have the application. So we're gonna double click it to execute it. It's gonna request us a password, which is the same way as if we are directly operating a unit. And once the software has opened, we are going to connect it. Parameters are already preloaded, so we just click OK. And now we can see our digital gas detector on the computer. The current value is 0 ppms. It is an ammonia sensor on the range from 0 to 100 ppms. And here you can see the status of the relays. Relay 1 and 2 are not energized because there is no alarm. And safety relay 3, it's energized as it should be. You can also see the 4 to 20 milliamp output. Now we are going to put the digital gas detector into service mode, and for that we are going to click this button on the top left, that is an S. The moment we click it, the gas detection goes into service mode and we are allowed to see the other buttons that are here on the right. We're going to go to parameter and click local alarm relays in order to activate all different options. The first menu we are going to take a look is the one called MP, which is measuring point. This is your ammonia sensor. And since this one has the address 1, we are going to enter the value 1 and click read measuring point. Now we are reading the sensor. The sensor is an ammonia, 100 ppm range, and we can see that it has two alarm levels, one in 25 ppm and another in 35 ppm. The way that these alarms react is alarm 1 activates relay 1 and alarm 2 activates relay 2. We can also assign those relays and alarms to be activated when there is a fault or have the alarm latching, which means that it will stay on regardless if the gas is gone until someone acknowledges the alarm. If we want to do a change in some of these parameters, for example, if we want to change the threshold from 25 ppm to 20 ppm, all we have to do is enter the new value of the alarm, which in this case will be 20, and then click the button Write Measuring Point. By writing the measuring point, we have changed the first threshold from 25 to 20 ppm. Another function of this menu is that we can export all these parameters into a CSV file that can be then sent by mail to a different location for other digital gas detector to be set up exactly the same way. And by the same means, we can import parameters from another digital gas detector to have a duplicate of that one. So we're going to move to the next menu, which is the relays. Here we can read each one of the three different relays that we have. So we are going to start by number 1 and click read relay. So relay number 1 is use. If I want to deactivate the relay, I click here and it goes to unused. So I'm going to keep it on use. Then you can see that the default setting of this relay is de-energized, which means that when there is an alarm, it will energize. But we can change that to be the opposite. It is a static relay, but I can change it to be flashing. So when it activates, it goes on and off. And it is controlled locally by this digital gas detector. But if I have a system that is connected to a central gas controller, I can change that to be controlled remote also. The same way that we have seen with the measuring point, we can export and import parameters from other relays. And here you can see also the parameters of relay number 2. We enter a value number 2 and we set grid relay. The next parameter, the next menu is the system parameter. Here we can see the values of this digital gas detector. So we enter the address 1 because this is number 1 and we click grid device. It's going to give us the serial number. On the system parameters menu, we can see the details of the complete digital gas detector, the same way we have seen with the relays and the measuring point. On the next button, you can see that it's called calibration. So when we click on this one, a calibration window pops up. And here we have our sensor, which is an ammonia sensor. And through these screens, we can calibrate the sensor. We are going to enter all the different information in regards to who is doing the calibration and the different conditions. And if we follow on these screens, we are going to get to the part where we are going to have to enter the concentration, which in this case can be 50 ppm. We can put the serial number of the bottle, the flow that we are administrating to the gas detector. And if we calibrate by this means, it's going to create a PDF report of the calibration. The last menu, it's the operating data. And here we can see all the operating data of our digital gas detector. When we read the unit, we can see the maximum, minimum temperatures that it has seen, how many calibration it has had, the sensitivity left, and all the operational information on this unit. And the final feature of the PC tool is that we can record the readings of this gas detector. So on this button here, if we click Start History, now it is recording all readings in PPMs, alarms, errors, and any issue that the gas detector might present. And when we stop this recording, it's going to create a CSV file where we can see all these values. Once we have finished using our PC tool and we have completed the changes or the calibration that we needed to do, we will need to remove the service mode from that gas detector. In order to do that, we are going to click again the button on the top left with the S. Once the service mode is off, you can see that the buttons to the right are not enabled anymore, only the one to do recording. If we want to disconnect the PC tool from the gas detector, we will have to click this button right here, which name is disconnect. The moment we click this button, the PC tool is disconnected from the gas detector. And now we can unplug the connection from the gas detector and the USB from the computer. And that's how you operate your PC tool using your computer. For more videos like this, visit our YouTube channel, Danfoss Cool US, and thanks for watching.